Golden Kingdoms is an exciting new view of the arts of the ancient Americas. We follow what we call the Golden Road, the development of gold working from the lands of the Inca to the lands of the Aztecs, covering some 2,000 years and about 6,000 miles. Luxury arts are characteristically high-value works, but relatively small in scale and lightweight. They're works that are worth carrying across distances as royal gifts or as sacred offerings. These very precious things were a major way ideas were exchanged between regions. We're featuring some thrilling new archaeological discoveries that include the regalia of powerful women. Years ago, we would have spoken about nose ornaments, and we would have said they were only worn by men, but we can't say that now. We know they were worn by women. One of my favorite objects is what's known as a serpent labret. It was an ornament that was worn through the lower lip. The tongue could actually move as the wearer moved, and it would have been worn by Aztec rulers. There's the fisherman's treasure. It's a Mixtec ornament, a war shield, marked with a crown and the letter C. That means it had already been looted by the Spaniards. It was going to Spain and the ship sank. I'm certain if the shield had made it to Spain, it would have been melted down. It was only recovered in the 1970s by an octopus fisherman off the coast of Veracruz. I think it really underscores how rare these works are. Another extraordinary object is what's known as a feather painting, made almost entirely of feathers from the macaw, from the cotinga, from the hummingbird. We tend to think of gold as the most important material, but other materials such as jade or feathers were considered far more valuable than gold. So it's an opportunity to think about inherent or universal value, also to get closer to some of the greatest artists known from the ancient Americas.